Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. Now, before we enter into today's presentation, I just want to give you a brief recap of what we covered last time. Last time we focused on the demon soul, and I gave you the third segment, which was now part three. And inside part three, we revealed the genesis of demons, which was the evil spirits which possessed the fallen angels. And I gave you the whole evolution of evil spirits, fallen angels, and demons. And today we want to enter into yet another exclusive dimension inside the Word of God. And today the Spirit of the Lord has instructed me once again to get into one of the highest and deepest exposures inside the Word of God. And today I want to expose Bermuda Triangle. And inside the Bermuda Triangle exposure, I want to expose the powers and the foundations of hell, and hoping that the Spirit of the Lord will guide me as the Word of God will prevail in this presentation. So, child of God, in exposing Bermuda Triangle, which is a controversial presentation in the Spirit, I want to pray with you before we get inside the Word of God, and praying that the Holy Spirit utters through me and inspires the ministration of the Word of Revelation. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am praying that you give me a depth of the Word, a word ministration that does not come from my carnal mind, but a word ministration that will be uttered by the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Let us get into scriptures in the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 6. And it reads, "And God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters." And these words are being spoken by God in the middle of creation. And he is dividing the waters in the midst of the waters, and dividing the waters from the waters. And when all this is happening, the earth is already a void platform. There are fallen angels that have already fallen, and amongst the fallen angels is the archangel, who is none other than Lucifer the devil, who has fallen with a league of angels, categories of angels, criterias of angels that have fallen to form a kingdom. And as God is separating the waters beneath and the waters above, he separates also the waters from the waters. And beneath the waters from the waters, there was a kingdom that fell under the water. And part of that kingdom that fell under the water was the marine kingdom of marine demons. And beneath the waters was another kingdom that fell under the water. But under the water was a spiritual kingdom, not just a spiritual kingdom, that was formed by Lucifer the devil. I'm talking about a city underneath the sea, a city that is constructed by evil spirits, a city that is constructed by Lucifer. And he has constructed a city underneath the sea. It is a mystery city. It is a mysterious kingdom where all evils, they dwell. And that city is connected to the underworld. And that city that is connected to the underworld is a city beneath, under the sea. You can only get there in spirit. You cannot get there in the physical. For you to get there, you can only get there in the spirit. And as I'm presenting unto you today, I want you to know that this is a place that I, as the revelator, the deep undercover, I have invaded this place in the spirit. A kingdom that is constructed and built, it has got infrastructure in the spirit. A kingdom that is guarded by Lucifer, the devil, and his demons. A kingdom that is guarded by Lucifer, and he has given his right hand as the queen, and the queen is in charge of that empire, and the queen has ordained her princesses, and the kingdom has got a hierarchy of demonic ranks that are assigned from the underworld unto that city which is under the sea. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. And God said, let the waters under the heaven be gathered together into one place, which are called the seas. And the waters were gathered into one place, and the dry land also appeared, which is the earth where I am located right now in the physical, not in the spirit. And this dry land, which is called the earth, is separated from the gathering together of the waters which are called the seas. And now when we talk about the seas, we are talking about a platform which is not the triangle entrance, but the seas where the marine kingdom, where the serpent marine kingdom is located, a place underneath the ocean where you cannot enter in the physical, but you can only enter in the spirit. Let us go to the book of Daniel chapter 7 verse 1, which breaks this kingdom into pieces, as I'm exposing also the underworld powers and the foundations of hell. In the first year of Belshazzar, king of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of the head upon his bed. When he's talking about the visions of the head, he's talking about the ministration of the Holy Spirit through meditation. Then he wrote the dream and told the sum of the matters. Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, the four winds of the heaven strove upon the great sea. The four winds, meaning the four angels that guard the four corners of the earth. And now the four winds of the heaven strove upon the great sea, and the four great beasts came up from the sea, diverse one from another. The four great beasts are the four demonic strongholds that guard the four corners of the seas, and they guard the territory of Bermuda Triangle. The first was like a lion. The lion is the one that is the king. The lion is the one that is in charge. The lion is the beast that is in charge, not only in charge inside the sea, but in charge of the dry land. And yet the eagle's wings, the eagle's wings are the spirits in the high places, and it is the stronghold which has the wings that guard the firmament. Remember, when God separated the waters above and the waters beneath, there was a space of the firmament that was left between the waters beneath and the waters above, and that space is represented by the eagle's wings, which represented the firmament powers. And I beheld till the wings were plucked off, and it was lifted up from the earth, and made to stand upon the feet as the feet of men. These powers, they don't dwell inside the sea. They dwell under the sea, but they come from deep under the sea, and they empower men who dwell upon this dry land. And a man's heart was given unto it. And when the scripture says a man's heart was given unto it, it's talking about the powers of hell and Hades that dwell inside Bermuda Triangle, and behold, another beast, second, rose from the great powers, and as it rose with mighty strength, and a second like that which appeared as a bay, and you know the strength of a bay, and it raised up itself on one side, and it had three ribs in the mouth of it between the teeth, and they said, arise, devour much flesh. These demons from the underworld, they strive and they feed on the flesh. After this I beheld, and lo, like a leopard, which had upon the back of its four wings of a fowl, the beast also had four heads, and dominion was given unto it. All these beasts that were seen, they represent the four powers from the underworld, the four powers which are led by Lucifer. After this I saw in the night visions, and behold, the fourth beast, dreadful and terrible and strong exceedingly, it had the great iron teeth, it devoured and break in pieces, and stamped the least Jew with the feet of it, and it was diverse from all the beasts that were before it, and it had 10 horns. The 10 horns, they represent the 10 kings that are ordained in 10 continents, which represent the superpowers ordained by the underworld. I considered the horns, and behold, there came up among them another little horn, before whom there were three of the first horns plucked up by the roots, and behold, in this horn were eyes like the eyes of men, and a mouth speaking great things. So it's talking about the three powers, and the three powers, they are represented by the three authorities of the three strongholds empowered by the devil from underneath. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit, whose garment was white as snow, who is the Son of Man, and the hair of his head like that of pure wool. His throne was like the fiery flame, and his wheels is the burning fire. And a fierce stream issued and came forth from before him. Thousands, thousands ministered unto him, and 10,000 times stood before him, and judgment was set, and the books were opened. Now the part there which was being read is the part that is giving the last hour before hell and Hades and the underworld and the Bermuda Triangle, they are thrown into the everlasting fire of hell. And I beheld then, because of the voice of the great words which were spoken by the horn, I beheld even till the beast was slain, and his body was destroyed and given to the burning flame. As concerning the rest of the beast, they had their dominion taken away, yet their lives were prolonged for a season and time. And I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven, and descended upon this earth, and came to the Ancient of Days, and brought him near. And there was given dominion and glory over all the kingdoms, all over all the nations, to rule down here on earth, and rulership above all the people, rulership above all the nations, the languages, and all that should serve him. And I, Daniel, was grieved in my spirit, in the midst of my body, and the visions of my head troubled me. And I came near unto one of them that stood by, and asked the truth, and he told me the interpretations, and said, these great beasts which are four are the four kings which shall rise out of the earth. The four kings that shall rise out of the earth are the powers from the underworld, ordained by Lucifer. And one of the powers is Baphomet. And one of the powers is the god of this earth, the god of the seas, and the god of the firmament. All these, they ordain rulers. I'm soon going to be explaining about who really is Baphomet, as the scripture will be giving me the reference. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever. Then I would know the truth of the fourth beast, which was diverse from all others, exceeding dreadful, whose teeth were of iron, and the nails of brass, which devoured, breaking pieces and stamping the residue of the feet. And this beast represents the world system. The world system that is ruled by technology. The world system that is engineered by men. The world system that is ruled by men. And of the 10 horns that were in his head, and of other which came up, and before whom 3 fell, even of that horn that had eyes and a mouth that spake many great things, whose look was more stooty than his fellows, and prevailed. And the same horn he made war with the saints, and prevailed against them. And this is the season where the saints of God shall fight, but the great beast and the great underworld, which is located from Bermuda Triangle, shall prevail over the saints for a season, until the Ancient of Days, who is the Son of Man, and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High, and the time of the Most High, and those who dwell under him shall come, and they shall possess the kingdom. And Daniel chapter 8 verse 1. And in the third year of the reign of King Belshazzar, a vision appeared unto me, even unto me, Daniel, after that which appeared unto me at the first. And I saw a vision, and it came to pass, when I saw that I was in the palace, which is in the province of Elam, and I saw a vision. Then I lifted up my eyes, and saw, behold, there stood a ram which had 2 horns. And the 2 horns, they represent the dragon. And the 2 horns, they represent the underworld prince, who is Lucifer, the devil. And the 2 horns, again, they represent Baphomet, which is a sign of 2 fingers. And the 2 horns were high, but one was higher than the other. And the higher one, which represents Lucifer, came up last. And I saw the ram pushing westward and northward and southward. Why? Because he was in charge of all corners of the world, so that no beast might stand before him. Neither was there any that could deliver out of his hand. But he did according to his will, and he became great. And as I was considering, behold, a he-goat came from the west, and on the face of the whole earth, and touched not the ground. And the goat had not a bone between the eyes. This goat is Baphomet, who is the representation of Lucifer, the right hand of Lucifer. The left hand is the queen of Bermuda Triangle. And he came to the ram. The ram, who is a significance of the reflection of the underworld, that had 2 horns, that represent Baphomet, who is the right hand, who is the representative of Lucifer, which I had seen standing before the river. And the river is the sea, which represented the triangle entrance, and ran unto him in the fury of his power. And I saw him come close to the ram, and he was moved with a representation, and break 2 horns. And there was no power in the ram Why? Because now was coming the manifestation of he that was greater than him. And he cast him to the ground and stamped upon him. And there was none that could deliver the ram out of his hand. Therefore, the eagle waxed very great, who is Baphomet. And when he was strong, the great one was broken. And Baphomet ruled the whole world and initiated the believers and initiated the entertainers and initiated the politicians and initiated the four notable ones, which are the four corners of the world, towards the four winds of the heaven. And out of one of them came forth a little horn, which was the exceeding great towards the south, ordained by Baphomet, who is the representative of Lucifer, and towards the east and towards the pleasant land. And it waxed great, even the host of heaven, and it cast down some of the host and of the stars to the ground, meaning that he was given the power over the stars that fell from heaven, that ruled the firmament, and he stamped upon them. Yet he magnified himself even to the prince of the host. He magnified himself as a representative of the prince, who is Lucifer himself, the one that rules Bermuda Triangle, and the one that rules hell and Hades. And the daily sacrifice was taken away, and the place of his sanctuary was cast down as a representation of all the sacrifices. All initiations were presented unto Baphomet, who is the goat with the two horns, who is greater than the ram, who was just a reflection of the goat himself. And a host was given him against the daily sacrifices by reason of the transgression that was done in the four corners of the earth. And it was cast down the truth to the ground, and it practiced and prospered. Then I heard one saint speaking, and another saint said unto a certain saint which spake, how long shall be the vision concerning the daily sacrifice? And this vision was a vision which was to be represented by the last hour unto 2,300 days. Then shall the sanctuary be cleansed. And it came to pass, when I myself, Daniel, had seen a vision and had sought for the meaning, then behold, there stood before me an appearance of a man. Why? Because the rulership of the underworld kingdom and the Bermuda Triangle will need the appearance of a man. And the man who will rule the four corners of the world and rule all the kingdoms of the world. So he came near me where I stood, and when he came, I was afraid, and he fell before him upon my face, and he said unto me, Son of man, for at the time of the end shall be this vision, where one ruler shall be ordained by the powers of hell, the powers of the underworld, the foundations of Bermuda Triangle. Now, as he was speaking with me, I was in a deep sleep on my face towards the ground, and he touched me and set me upright and said, behold, I will make you understand the interpretation of this whole vision. The ram which you saw having two horns are the kings of Media and Persia. Those are kingdoms that still reign. Persia is a kingdom in the realm, and Media is a realm down here that gives authority on rulers. And the rough god is the king of Grecia, and the great one that is between the eyes is the first king, which represents Lucifer. Now that being broken, whereas four stood up for it, four kingdoms shall stand up out of the nation, not in his power, but in the later times of the kingdom. When the transgressors are come to the full, a king of fierce conscience and understanding dark sentences shall stand up. And this is the king who shall rule the whole world, and his power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. And he shall destroy wonderfully, and shall prosper and take over this whole world, and practice and shall destroy mightily, and the holy people shall be subjected under this rule for a certain season. Child of God, this whole vision is complicated. Even I, as the revelator, I do not have full understanding, but this is the vision which the Lord said, it is yet to come to pass. But this is the vision that also exposes the powers that come from the underworld of Bermuda Triangle, the powers of different categories of powers, the powers of different categories of ranks, which multiply from the underworld and the foundations that are deep underworld, and the foundations that rise and they take over this world in the four corners of the earth, and they rise up into the firmament powers of heaven. When I'm talking about the firmament powers of heaven, I'm talking about the firmament powers of the fallen princes that guard the four corners of the powers of the air. You know that the prince and the power of the air is the same prince who is regarded as the king of the underworld, who shall rise and take over this world and fight against the saints. Child of God, I am praying that you are given the knowledge and the wisdom against the beasts that shall rise in form of the underworld, in form of the dry land, in form of the seas, in form of the operations of this world, in form of the technology of this world, in form of all the powers that rule the firmament, the powers that be in the air. I'm praying right now that you're given the power over Bermuda Triangle, which rules not just the underworld, not just hell and Hades, not just the marine powers, but rules also the firmament. And I'm praying that you're given the strength of the Holy Spirit to stand guard and guard your territory against the kingdom of the devil, against the kingdom of all the powers, the likes of Baphomet, the likes of the Illuminati, the likes of the Queen of Bermuda Triangle, the likes of all the demons that guard, the gatekeepers of the underworld, the gatekeepers in the realms and dimensions of the spirit. I am praying in the name of Jesus. La sakarabasota, jakarabasota, lirabasata. I'm given the power to address these kingdoms by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by the generals in the spirit, John the Revelator, the mantle that sees beyond, the mantle of Daniel that sees beyond, the mantle of the generals in the spirit, the mantle of angel Michael, who holds all the wars of heaven, the wars of the firmament, the one that will bind the dragon and lock him for 1,000 years. Rikapasata labasota, laprasotemosita. I'm binding the underworld. I'm binding the powers that rule the four corners of the earth, the powers that rule the four corners of the underworld, the powers that rule the four corners of the firmaments, the powers in the realms and dimensions, the powers of the foundations of hell, and the powers deep down in the Bermuda Triangle. In the name of Jesus, I expose.